5 here, and I'm here to bring you a Wi-Fi battle from Pokemon Showdown. Now this is an underused battle, and I'm using my underused team. Now before I show you the battle, let me show you the Pokemons first. First we have Yanmega with the item Life Orb, ability Speed Boost, moves Air Slash, Bug Buzz, Giga Drain for HP recovery, and Hidden Power Ground to deal with Steel, Fire, Poison, and Electric types. Now I give it 128 on Speed since because it already has Speed Boost. And so I give the rest on HP so it can take hits pretty well. Next we have Machamp with the item choice scarf, ability No Guard. With No Guard it will never miss. Dynamic Punch and Stone Edge will never miss. And I give it Poison Jab for Fairy type and Knockoff for Psychic types. I give it 152 on attack and speed. Next we have Arcanine. I use this as a defensive wall. This is why it has an Intimidate and Will-O-Wisp and Rocky Helmet. I also give it Morning Sun, Flamethrower, and Extreme Speed. I give 252 EVs on defense, 128 on HP, and 64 on both attack and special attack. Next is the special defensive wall, Tentacruel, which I mainly use it to remove hazards and take special attacks pretty well. I also use it to set up Toxic Spikes and Venus Shock to deal more damage on poisoned opponents. Next, we have Mega Swampert, which is an all-around Pokemon that has a high attack and high defense and special defense. It does really well. I also use it to set up Stealth Rocks. Finally, we have Salamence with the item Choice Scarf and ability Moxie. I give it Earthquake, Outrage, Crunch, and Rock Slide. It has 252 on attack, 128 on speed and HP. Now looking at her team, I'm not sure what she wants to lead off with, so I just lead off with Arcanine to get Intimidate off. Now she leads off with Swoobat, goes for the Combine with the simple ability, and Ahira you just go for the Will-O-Wisp, just so she can lose a bit of health every turn. I switch into Tentacruel just as Death Father since it's pretty much pointless in the match looking at her Pokemons. And with two Psychics, my Tentacruel is dead. Now here, I actually switch into Salamence with the Choice Scarf and Crunch. I go for it and it lives with 1 HP. And with Citrus, with the Citrus Berry and Roost, it has more HP than it had before. Now here she knows that I'm Scarfed and goes for Malamar to take the Crunch. I go for Arcanine forgetting that Malamar has the contrary ability. But even with the +1, it still doesn't do much, which is good. Now here I just go for the Will-O-Wisp just to have her attack, which works in my favor. Since the next Psychic Cut won't do anything even with that 2+ attack. I go for the Morning Sun to replenish my HP. As she goes for the Superpower, still increasing her attack. Now here I go for Yanmega while she goes for the rest, which tells me it's a Sleep Toxic, so it's a good thing I switch into Yanmega. I go for the Bug Buzz and she switches into Swoobat as Death Father. Now here she sends out her Tyrantrum telling me that it's Choice Scarf. I switch into Swampert just to take the Rock type move, and I take this opportunity to set up Stealth Rock. While she switches into Clawitzer, I go for the Earthquake, and with two Earthquakes, it's pretty much dead. Now here she switches into Kecleon, and I thought I could live a Sucker Punch, but with the crit as you can see here, I guess I couldn't. Now here I switch into Machamp, go for the knockoff, predicting the Shadow Sneak, which works in my favor. And with two knockoffs, she's dead, and I'm pretty sure she doesn't know I'm Scarfed, so she goes for the normal type move while I finish her off with a knockoff. Now here she switches into Malamar, I go for Yanmega, just to take the superpower, but she gets a Psycho Cut, which still doesn't do much. I go for the Bug Buzz, she switches into Tyrantrum, and the Bug Buzz does a lot of damage, almost killing the Tyrantrum. Now here I switch into Arcanine just for Death Father, and with the Rocky Helmet I will take the Tyrantrum out with me, which works in my favor. Now she has two Pokemon left. I predict her to lead off with the Frost Lass, so I go with Machamp, and here I go for the Stone Edge. And I live with Psychic, which is actually good. Now it's basically 1-1-3, and with Yanmega I pretty much won the game. So good game, Aleth, and thank you for the match. Actually, as you can see here, I will not sing that my Salamence will easily take care of Malamar. Actually, not with ease, but with a crit. And with a crit, I've won the game. Thank you, Aleth, for the match.
Oh, this is another Wi-Fi battle I had. Looking at my opponent's team, I'm thinking that he will lead off with Galvantula, so I lead off with the Arcanine. And I was right. I expect the Stick Whip, so I just go for the Flamethrower, but he predicts that and goes for Chandelure to get the Flash Fire boost. I switch into my special wall to take any hit he wants to throw at me. Now here I take the opportunity to set up Toxic Spikes. I set up the first layer while he switches into Blissey. And here I set the second one up, and he goes for the Thunder Wave, which isn't a big deal. Now here I decide to switch into Swampert. For some reason I thought he would go for Thunder Wave again, I don't know why. So anyways, when I switch into Swampert, I take this opportunity to set up, I go for the Earthquake, sorry. And he switches into Whimsicott to take any ground or water move I want to throw at it. So here I switch into Tentacruel, predicting the Leech Seed or Giga Drain, and with Liquid Ooze, instead of gaining health, it will lose health. And with Toxic, it's losing more health and more health. And here I switch into Arcanine, and I get the Intimidate off. Now here, for some reason, I stay in, thinking I can take an Earthquake pretty well, but I don't, and I go for the Flamethrower, and it doesn't do much. Now here I'm pretty scared, and I switch into... Now here I go for the Extreme Freeze, predicting him to go for an Ice move, predicting me to switch into Salamence or Red Mega. But he actually goes for Blissey, I go for Swampert. And now here I just go for Earthquake. I take the opportunity to set up Stealth Rocks. And he goes for the Seismic Toss. I go for Earthquake, he goes for the Seismic Toss again, I go for another Earthquake. And he switches into Whimsicott to take the Earthquake. Now he just has 8 HPs left, so if he stays in, he's gonna die from Toxic. I switch into Tentacruel, protecting the Leech Seed again. He goes for it, and he actually dies thanks to Liquid Ooze. Now here he switches into Abzol. I actually switch into Arcanine just to get the Intimidate off, and I actually sack my Arcanine. He goes for the Mega Evolution, goes for the knockoff, and he gets some damage thanks to Rocky Helmet. And now with Toxic, he is getting even more damage. I switch into Mega, go for the Bug Buzz, and he switches into Chandelure since it resists, it four time resists Bug type moves, being Fire and Ghost. And now here I switch into my special wall once again to take any hits he wants to throw at me, and he goes for the Fire Blast or Flamethrower, Fire Blast. And I take it pretty well, the Tentacruel is a monster. Now here he switches into Mamoswine while I switch into Swampert. I actually switch into Mega, predicting the Earthquake, but he actually goes for the Icicle Crash and he knocks me out, which isn't a big deal since Mega isn't that important. Now here it's basically the end. I switch into Salamence, my choice card Salamence, go for the Outrage, kill the Galvantula, get the Moxie boost. He switched into Abzol, and for some reason he didn't go for Sucker Punch. I was locked into Outrage and he didn't go for Sucker Punch. Now here I'm confused, he switches into Blissey. I actually stay in and see if I can go through the confusion, which I actually do. I take the Blissey out. And now he has one more Pokemon left and it's pretty much dead since it's poisoned and with Stealth Rocks it's pretty much dead. He goes for a Shadow Ball, doesn't take me out. I go through the confusion and take it out. And Salamence is a beast.